considering you have many lawmakers who already want the ban, how, other than the income that you believe, no, it will increase, and I'm sure what you feel is it would help the budget at some point, is POGO is illegal in China itself. So what is the biggest argument? Why are we insisting that?
Because if we ban them, you will just drive them underground and you have worse social costs. You will have more of those prostitution, you will have more of those kidnapping, you will have more na hindi naman kidnapping. Rather than have orderly and systematic approach to it, we have a law, Republic Act 11590, which was just actually last week been sinabi ng Supreme Court as being valid. And second, there is a physical way of addressing it. One, by the combination of NBI and PNP, having more, including the BID.
Okay.
And third is really through physically ring fence the operations of POGO.
Okay.
Because if you drive down an entire, can you stop the digitalization of gambling? No. So I will only agree that the social cost will be worse if you can stop the digitalization of gambling.
Mm. You also said that I want to know, can you confirm this? You said that 70,000 Filipinos will lose their jobs if there's a ban on POGO?
Yung direct kasi nasa 20,000 eh, according to PAGCOR. And according to Lichu, 70,000 ang Filipinos who are employed in several sources.
You mean kasi David Lichu? David Lichu, the real estate business person, right? Yes.
Yes, that's correct.
Go on. Just
so, and ang kagandahan naman ito, if you ban it, kasi ang ginawa ng mga Pilipino dito, nagpagawa ng mga office building, pero kinontrata natin to sa mga POGO for the entire term, like 5 years, 7 years. So now, if you ban it, so pinapagbayad natin yung mga POGO for almost 1.6 million square meters of office space. Now down, it's down to 1.06. Now if you ban it, then that will be a force majeure. And therefore, itong mga office space na to, I will be considered na they're out of the contract, basically.
Okay.
So you will have 1 million office space. So okay. It's not that I am, I am dismissive of the social cost. But my point here is that the social cost will be worse if you ban POGO. You will drive down an entire industry that you cannot prevent because the future is digital.
All right. Now, just to end, just very quickly, the challenge with the new budget is, of course, revenue sourcing. Other than the loans that, of course, this government would have to take, what other measures are you seeing for the government to have more revenues to actually fund the 2023 budget? Because POGO would have been one of them, right? And you're saying PAGCOR privatization is possibly one. So you want that implemented fast. What are the others, Chairman, that makes you hopeful?
There will be taxes that are Pigovian in nature. In other words, these are taxes that do not hurt the poor, hurts the rich. But however, the entire 2023 budget is actually premised on no new taxes. It is premised on a 0.3% increase in tax collection efficiency and a 7% GDP growth rate. No new taxes. That is the premise of the 2023 budget.
All right. Well, on that note, Chairman Joey Salceda, it's been insightful speaking with you this morning. I hope to have you again, sir. Thank you so much for joining me.
Thank you. Thank you.
And thank you,
good luck with your voice.
Thanks. Thank you. Thank you.